Hello dear students, very good morning to you all. In today's class I teach you nested if statement available in C language. In my last two classes I taught you simple if as well as I taught you if else. Simple if was one way decision making statement, if else was two way decision making statement. In today's class whichever I am going to teach you, this is multi way decision making statement available in C language. You can call it as multi-way decision making, or you can call it as multi-way conditional statement, or branching statement, or selection statement available in C. Why do we call multi-way? Because machine follows one of the multiple blocks. There will be multiple blocks. You can see this is the first block, this is the second block, this is the third block. All the three blocks will have some instructions. Computer system follows the instructions from one of the block. Here for machine there are three choices. This is the first block, this is the second block, this is the third block. But machine follows one of the block depending on given conditions. That's why this statement is called as multi-way. You can see this flowchart. This is one set of statements, second set of statements, third set of statements. Machine follows one of them. If the first condition is true, second is also true. First is also true, second is also true, then machine follows instructions from first block. First is true, second is false, then machine follows the second block of statements. If the first one is false, machine follows the third block of statements. That means machine is following one of the three blocks, not all the three. Afterwards followed by statement X. So it is called as a multi-way decision making statement available in C language. In exam, in VTV examination, if you get a question on nested if, I request you to explain, then write the syntax, then draw the flowchart, then if you have time you can write working of nested if, then give some examples. If you do so, you get very good marks in exam. Let us start. First to discuss how to explain nested if in examination. Simple points you can write. This is a multi-way decision making statement available in C. It executes one of the multiple blocks based on given condition. That condition depends on the problem whichever we are going to solve by using a computer system. So it is called multi-way decision making statement or conditional statement. What do you mean by nest in C language? Using within one another. If you use if within the if, that is called nested if. If you use if else within if, you can call it as nested if. That means in if only, if you use another if, that is called as nested if. In if you can use if else also. Look at this syntax. This is the if. In this if I am using if else, you can call it as nested if. Or in if, simply if, this is nested if. In else part also you can use the simple if or if else. That means you can use the if statements within one another. If we use if statements within one another, that is what we call nested if in C language. While solving problems by using a computer system, we use if within the if, that is what we call nested if. These points you need to write in exam so that you can get good marks. Okay, let us come back. Then how to explain about the nested if in examination? Don't forget to write these three points. We can use if within if statement, or we can use if else within if. Using within one another is called nesting. Afterwards I teach you nested for also. Using for within for, nested while, using while within while. We can nest the control statements within one another. That helps us to solve complex problems. Okay, very good. If you explain like this, you get 0.5 marks. Then don't forget to write the syntax correctly. Syntax must be always correct. If you do mistakes, you are going to lose the marks in examination. If must be small letter. Instead of writing expression 1, you can write condition 1 also. Don't give semicolon here. Let us assume first one is also true, second is also true. Then machine follows the instructions from the first block followed by statement X. This is one possibility. If both are true, statement block 1 works followed by statement X. First is also true, second is also true, machine follows statements blocks 1 followed by statement X. This is one possibility. Let us assume first one is true but second is false. First is true, second is false means machine follows statements block 2. First is true but second is false. Then machine follows statement 2 followed by statement X. This is second possibility. Third, one more possibility as per the written syntax. First only false. First only false means machine will not enter into the body. First only false means machine executes the instructions from the else body. That means statements block 3 works. First is false. That means machine follows statement 3 followed by statement X. Oh, very interesting. This is what all about the syntax as well as flowchart. I request everyone to write it correctly in examination. I request everyone to draw the flowchart neatly, freehand sketch in less time. You need to practice before going to exam on paper. Oh, very good, very nice. This is what all about how to write the syntax. This is all about how to draw the flowchart. Now you scored 1 mark for syntax, 1 mark for flowchart, 1 mark for explanation. You scored 3 marks. Oh, very good. Then working of nested if, whatever I explained to you, that one you need to write on paper so that evaluator can read and evaluator can understand your explanation. If the given expressions like expression 1 and 2, if both are true, then machine follows instructions from statements block 1 followed by statement X. Oh, nice. If the given expression 1 is true but second is false, then machine follows the instructions from second block followed by statement X. Oh, very nice. If the expression 1 is false, then what happens? Machine follows statements block 3. Oh, very nice. One of the three blocks are going to work in this syntax. So it is called as multi-way decision making statement available in C language. Now you scored 4 marks in exam. 3 to 4 marks you scored. 1 marks for explanation, 1 marks for syntax, 1 marks for flowchart, and it may give you some more marks. You are getting appreciation from the evaluators or the teacher's side, means you get very good marks in examination. Next, don't forget to give the programming examples. One simple example I give on nested if. I request you to give this example in examination. That is to find largest of 3 unknown numbers. You can write code to find largest of 3 unknown values. Let us assume those 3 unknown values are available in A, B and C. Okay. Then let us assume the contents of A is more than B. Let us assume the contents of A is more than B means A is greater. If suppose A is greater than B, definitely A will be greater than B only. Then I check for whether that A is greater than C. Let us assume A is greater than B as well as A is greater than C. Now can you tell me which one will be the largest? Yeah, you are right. Definitely A will be the largest number. This is first possibility. I hope everyone has understood. If A is greater than B, if A is greater than C, definitely A will be the largest number. One more possibility is there. What is that? Let us discuss. A is greater than B. A is greater than B. But A is not greater than C. Then which one will be greater? A is greater than B. A is not greater than C. Means which one will be greater? C will be greater. That one you have to print. Okay. Then how to print the contents of the C variable? Just you can write here C. This is the second possibility. If A is greater than B, A is greater than C, A will be displayed. If A is greater than B, A is not greater than C means C will be greater. Okay. One more possibility is there. What is that? Let us assume A is not greater than B. A is not greater than B means else block works. If A is not greater than B, definitely B will be greater. A is not greater than B means B will be greater. Now I check whether that B is greater than C. Yeah, let us assume it is true. Control V is for paste. If B is greater than C, A is not greater than B. That means B is greater than A. B is greater than C? Yeah, that means B is greater. I hope everyone has understood. Shall I repeat once again? Okay, I repeat for you. If A is greater than B? No. That means B is greater than A. Whether that B is greater than C? Yes, that means B is greater. Okay. One more possibility is there. What is that? Let us assume A is not greater than B. A is not greater than B means B is greater than A. B is greater than C? No. No means which one will be greater? C will be greater. Oh, nice. This is the fourth possibility. This is what the good example for nested if. In if we used if else, in else also we used if else. Oh, very nice. Now you can write only this much. Now, for example, you can convert into program also. You have to print the message, enter three numbers. How to print the message? Enter three numbers. Oh, nice. The message will be displayed on terminal. How to read the numbers? Scanf. %d for decimal value. %d for second decimal value. %d is for third one. Whatever the first value I enter, that will be stored in A. Whatever the second value I enter, that will be stored in B. Whatever the third value I enter, that will be stored in C. Oh, nice. We are reading three values, then accordingly it works. But before using any variables, you need to define the variables. How to define? Already you know. We go for int A, comma B, comma C. Here my program started. Somewhere it needs to end. Now here it completes. Oh, nice. Here the program is over. Then as you know, all the instructions instructions must be within which function? Main function. Void main. Void means no return value to the operating system. Hash include, you need to add one header file. What is that? Standard input and output header file. Here my program started, here my program completed. The student who writes the code like this in exam, definitely that student gets good marks. Let us trace the program. Assume that I entered, now whenever I run a program, I get the message like enter three numbers. Just what I do? I enter one, I enter two, I enter three. Now A is greater than B, one is greater than two, no, else. B is greater than C, two is greater than C, two is greater than three, no, C will be printed. Means I get the output as three. Oh, very nice. This is the first one. Instead of 1, 2, 3, if you enter 2, 1, 3. 2 is greater than 1? Yeah, correct. A is greater than B? Yeah. 2 is greater than C? 2 is greater than 3? No. Print C. Oh, 3 will be printed. Oh, nice. Okay, one more possibility. You can take 3, 1, and 2. Okay. 3 is greater than 1? Yeah. 3 is greater than 2? Yeah. You may enter any values in any order, we get the largest only. This is what how to find the largest of three numbers using nested if statement available in C language. Instead of writing simply %d, you can take a largest number is text message also you can take. You can type it everywhere, right button. You can type it everywhere. You can take like this, largest number is copy, you can paste. Okay, you can paste here and you can paste here, control V. You have to use the control C and copy, cut, copy, paste as per the editor shortcut keys. Now I am working with MS Word, I am using, don't use these things in Ubuntu and Turbo. There are different shortcut keys in edit menu available, you can search it, you get it. Okay, now if you enter 1 and 3 and 2, we get the output like largest number is 3. The student who writes the example like this, definitely that student gets good marks in examination. Don't do any mistakes like don't give the semicolon for conditions, don't forget the semicolon for the instructions inside, don't type the if in uppercase. I request everyone to write the keywords in small letter. This is what all about the nested if. I hope everyone has understood. I request everyone to watch the video, understand, and frequently you can watch and write, practice on rough paper so that you can write in examination on paper with confidence. I hope everyone has understood. Thank you. Have a nice day. Take care.